Welcome back to Three Brothers Disc Golf. Today, Zach will be using the Kristen Tatar Pure versus Dad, who is using his entire bag.
Hole one, it's a par four, probably about 350 feet from the red, so not a long par four, very short, but we're going to see how the pure flies.
First throw with the pure, how do you like it?
Too much.
That was too much disc for that short of a shot.
Yeah, I could tell like halfway up there. Like I said, early release it, have it turn.
You good?
Then tap in his paw.
Two, Dad's leading by one. 255 feet, straight up the hill there. Basket's off a little bit to the right. You got woods on the right and left, so you want to just throw it straight.
It's a par three as well.
It's a par three. Yeah.
Alright, after first rough hole, we're gonna try to do good on this hole.
That's quite a plan.
Yeah, I know.
Nice throw.
It's up there for a putt.
Edge of circle made.
That was a very rainbowy putt. Good putt.
A rare birdie on hole two.
Takes a lead on that. Hole three, it's a par three, 211 feet. Pretty much just a straight shot. You do have a little bit of low ceiling since the branches are coming from the wood. Basket's kind of surrounded by a bunch of trees, so if anything, you want to be right of the basket so you have a more open putt at it. Oh gosh. Give me reasons to doubt, try to keep me down, I'll put the flame out, you can't get to me.
Alright, this is the excuse for our bad tee shots. Nice puddle in the middle of the tee pad. You got an obstructed putt, I think.
Oh.
You like going up in the air a lot.
Hole four, 211, to par three, up in a hard turn to the left. You're gonna have to hyzer in there. It's up on top of the hill. Par's a good score on this one. I need a par.
Push me down to the ground. Goes around.
bad kick.
That has two wrap. Great at it or high there.
Hole 5, par 3, about 175 feet. Baskets go straight up over the hill. There is a nice little gradual drop off behind the basket. So if you throw it long, you probably have a long putt coming back. You really don't want to go off to the right or left. There's a good amount of 3-yard shot.
Nice shot.
Could have skipped up there for you. Hole 6, 179 feet. Pretty simple, just a straight shot with a bunch of trees in the way. So if you miss that one tree in the middle, you're golden. There's OB long and to the right, so you don't want to, you know, cook it and get over in the swamp. They'll land it short and you have a birdie putt.
There's a drop zone if you go OB. Yep. About right there, I think.
Let's go.
Hey, I'm at the drop zone.
Nice.
Close.
Oh, so close.
Hole 7, so par 4, about 400 feet. Basket is up to the right. It is a nice little slope once you get over this hill. So your putts and up shots can roll away. But the first thing you want to do is probably get up to that pathway at the top of the hill.
Good.
Nice shot.
Okay. Uh-oh. What did you do?
I slipped a little. Kind of bent over it. And...
I forgot to hit record.
You skipped off the little rock. I think you're good. I think you're like 10 feet. That was a close one. And I've got my drop in. Right.
Yeah.
There.
Good birdie.
Thank you. Alright, we are playing an alternate layout where from hole 7 we go up to hole 12. Just cause it kinda, alright, after I was rudely interrupted.
We are going to hole 12 after hole 7 just because it kind of makes the flow of the course a bit better, in my opinion. It reduces walking. So we're at hole 12, and then from 12 we go through 18. Then from 18 we play 9, then from 9 we play 10, 11, and we end on 8, which is probably the hardest hole. But this is how we do the layout. Alright, hole 12, kind of 8 with the way we're playing right now. But par 3, about maybe 150 feet downhill. Just, you can kind of throw whatever you want at it. Dad likes, I think, the forehand or with the Loki. Nice short hole. There's a nice little log back there to kind of stop you. So, pretty simple.
Doink.
I knew it. Not doing for a lot.
Good layup.
This is our ninth hole, hole 13, John 316. It's 316 feet. The basket is tucked away in the little grove of trees over there. A big dip off the tee, you're elevated probably 20 feet. You just want to get it up there, get yourself a birdie putt.
Hey, I'm up there. Almost hit me.
Hold 14, about 320 feet, I'd say. Not much to say about this pull. There's kind of a line here for like a forehand flex shot. I can't really do that because I only have a putter, so the putter's not going to flex at all. But it's definitely going to be a tough hole. Only a par 3, so that's even tougher.
Probably saved the one gap. I wanted to side load.
Breaking out the tree hitter.
Hey! That was looking good, and then last second.
You okay? You're up there.
Yeah. Oh, I thought that would have been your shoulder.
Little, and I got my drop in par.
Hole 15, par 3, 175 feet. Little gully up and around, got some trees in the way. It's on the top of the hill back there. Looking for a birdie if you can get it.
It's
Come back.
No hole breakdowns because we gotta go fast.
No. Okay. I scared it was gonna go in the puddle.
Probably can't tell on the camera, but it is extremely muddy out here.
Not far enough.
This is a par 5.
Risking the pier to go for the eagle.
Oh, watch me hit the devil.
A little long.
Oh, I think you're just barely over.
No.
Oh.
Lick the basket.
Bad first par. Me for my birdie, kind of.
All right, thank you. That's a little deep. Come back.
Skip. Hey.
Not long, but.
Long like me.
Yeah.
It's still fine.
Yeah.
I went the other gap.
Too high.
You keep hitting high on these.
I know. Okay. Lack of practice.
Hey, long putt though. Birdie.
Yeah, so I beat Dad with the pier through, 15 holes?
Yep.
Minus three.
You were minus three, I was plus two. I could have made up 5 holes and 3 holes.
Five
shots and 3 holes.
But other than that, make sure to like and subscribe. We'll catch you on the next one.
Peace.